People often ask me, why are there crystals in the bottom of my maple syrup container and they look like this? Well, this is an indication that you've overcooked your maple syrup and the crystals are just the hardening up of the syrup over time. This also happens if you continue to reheat your syrup in the same container when you are serving it for a meal. If you heat it up real warm, over time it will crystallize as well. So it's not a bad thing. It's certainly better to overcook your syrup slightly versus undercooking your syrup slightly, where you'll start to get some mold growing in the syrup and you'll have to skim it off and reheat it. So having these small crystals in the bottom of your maple syrup container isn't a problem. What you should do is heat up maybe, let's say, some hot coffee. Pour it in the bottom of your container, swish it around in there, and it'll dissolve the maple sugar crystals, that hard maple rock candy. If your container is a little bigger and you can get them out, it is maple candy and it's very delicious. It's good to eat. So you can eat the maple candy. It's just pure maple syrup that's crystallized into a hardened form. So that's why you have crystals in the bottom of some of your maple syrup containers. Okay, here's the coffee that we've poured inside. We're just gonna let it start to dissolve some of these crystals. You can take your bottle or your container and swish it around so that coffee or hot liquid will help to dissolve the maple sugar crystals a lot faster. Okay, so we've swished around our glass jar and our maple hard candy in the bottom with our hot coffee, and you can see it's all gone. So, you know, it doesn't take very much effort and you get all your maple sugar back. You get to use it. And if you're like me and you like coffee, it goes right in the coffee mug. And it's a little extra sweet.